Hi everyone, my name is Berta and welcome back to my channel. Animal Crossing is all over the internet and I don't have a Switch. So I thought, how can I still participate in the Animal Crossing fun? And then I decided to make some Animal Crossing villagers as Sims. So that's what we're gonna do today. I chose two villagers, Fauna and Megan. I chose Fauna because, I don't know, I came across that villager on the internet and I thought she was absolutely cute, so personal preference. And I chose Megan because I was asking around on the internet which villagers were favorites of people and which they would want me to make as a sim, and someone commented that she wanted to have Megan as a sim, so that's what we're doing today. While making the Sims, I really tried to look at what the villagers look like and incorporate those features into the Sims. For example, Fauna has a very curved nose, but like on the inside. I don't know how to better describe that, but I think you can see what I mean. And I gave her the skin tone and the hair color that matches the fur of Fauna as a villager. And Megan was a bit more difficult, but I'll talk about that when we get to her. For Fauna, I also wanted to give her a hairstyle with space buns, or buns, because I thought that could represent the ears. I don't know if that's weird, but I thought it was cute. I went with this hairstyle, but I wanted to find like a nice different brown color, but I couldn't find one, so I ended up going with the EA brown hair color. Also, yesterday I got kind of scared because, if you didn't know, I have two guinea pigs, Maya and Luna, and my mom called, like not yesterday, but the day before, that Luna wasn't eating, and if a guinea pig stops eating, things are usually, you know, not good. So I came over yesterday and we took her to the vet and she was in really bad shape. And the vet felt like a big lump in her belly, which could be two things. It could be like a constipation, a blockage in her intestines, or it could be a tumor. So realistically, because she is already very old for a guinea pig, this could very well be a tumor, which meant that if she wouldn't start eating within a few days after the vet gave her some injections, that meant we would have to put her down. But this morning my dad texted me that she was eating again and she was walking around and being her happy self, and my mom later today also texted me that everything was going fine. So unless something crazy happens, this was just a big constipation, which is now gone, and I'm so happy about that. I'm so relieved, you guys. I was very scared I was gonna lose my guinea pig. Do you remember the book I was talking about in my previous video? It's called A Little Life by Hanya Yanagihara. I finished it. I cried. And I recommend it to everyone. Just if you want to read it, which you should, just be aware of all the, you know, difficult topics that are discussed. Like, look at the trigger warnings before starting to read this. But it was so heartbreaking and such a beautiful story. Like, it's a very big book, so whether you listen to it or you read it in physical form, it'll take you a long time. But it's such a detailed description of someone's life, and you really get to know the main character Jude, and it feels like you know him inside out, like he's your closest friend. But the story is so beautiful but heartbreaking. But go read it, please. Now I'm reading the audiobook Eleanor Oliphant Is Completely Fine, and it has some good reviews, so I'm really excited to finish that one. Please do let me know, are you a reader or are you not? And if you are a reader, what kind of books do you like and which do you recommend to me? Because I always like to get some more book recommendations. Some books that I really like are, let me see, the Cemetery of Forgotten Books series by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. I really like the Mistborn trilogy by Brandon Sanderson, which is fantasy, and also the other fantasy series, the Kingkiller Chronicles by Patrick Rothfuss. I really like the Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. I'm just looking through my Goodreads. If you want to add me on Goodreads, feel free to do so. You should be able to find me by my name. Those are the ones I would recommend. I also really like Harry Potter, but if you are a reader, chances are that you have already read that. So those are my recommendations for you in case you needed some. Also, as I told you before, if you've been here, you know about this, but I'm having some mental health struggles, which I need help for. And so I went to a clinic in order to get help, and I had an intake. But then the virus thingy exploded, and now I cannot get any help until at least June, because they need to do some tests that, you know, require face-to-face contact, and of course we can't do that at the moment. So I am not getting the help I need, which also is resulting in me probably going to stop with my education, which sucks because I really just want to be able to finish my studies, you know, but at the moment it doesn't seem like I can. I mean, that sucks, but on the other hand, I will have more time for videos. Trying to look at the positive side of things, okay? So, I would like to know from you guys what kind of videos you would like me to make. And, you know, they can be within my comfort zone. You can request, like, certain Create-A-Sim videos. I'm happy to do that. But also, if you have ideas for something completely different, like a Let's Play, a challenge, or speed builds that you want me to do, please do let me know, because now I have the time, I will reconsider and rethink what I'm going to do with my channel the coming few weeks. So please let me know if you have any ideas. We have also now come to Megan. This sim was so difficult. As you could have seen in the thumbnail, Megan is like a purplish pink bear. To me, she seems like kind of like a mother figure that is in the kitchen baking cookies for you. So that's what I kind of base her personality and her looks on. But I didn't have any good-looking hairstyles in a shade of purple that suited her fur color. And so it took me ages to find something that I liked. And even so, I'm not completely happy with the hairstyle that I gave her. But, you know, it is what it is. I did my best. So I really hope you do like it. Also, their outfits, you know, I have used some CC, so if you want me to make a CC list, please do let me know, because I'm not going to make one as of yet, but if you really want to have the custom content that I used, let me know and I will make one. But her main outfit, the dress that she's going to wear, and also the dress that Fauna is wearing, are both from The Sims game itself. They are from, I believe, movie night stuff, is that what it's called? And I don't know the dress that Megan wears, I don't know which pack that is from, but they are both from expansion packs from The Sims, so I can't give you the links to those because they're in the game. So there you go. I ended up giving Megan this shorter hairstyle. I really did wanted to give her a shorter hairstyle. I thought that suited her face better than long hairstyles. And I gave her, like, it doesn't look perfect, the purple colors in her hair, because they're not meant for this hairstyle, but I think they look natural enough to look realistic. So I gave her these purple hair streaks. Am I making sense? I don't know. My English is not the best today, but you get what I mean. And also, at first I wanted to give her yellow eyeshadow or purple, but that just, it looked too much, so I changed that up in the end into something a bit more neutral, which suited her face a bit more, in my opinion. Also, her green eyes... That was my boyfriend coughing. Her green eyes are very, very green, but I based it on her actual, like on Megan's actual eyes, so that's why they are so green. And I gave her these stars, freckles, makeup things, because she has, the Megan villager has blue freckles, so I wanted to give her these starry freckles. But I also made a version of her without the freckles, so if you don't like them, there's also a version where she's not having them on her face. We are almost at the end of the video, so in the comments, please let me know which villagers you like the most, and if you like this video, do you want to see another one where I make some of your favorite villagers? Please let me know. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!